So recently, Meta launched the largest ever open-source model, Llama 3.1, the 405 billion parameter version publicly, which means for the first time, we have an open-source model that is comparable, if not better, than the closed models like Gemini, GPT-4, or Claude. So naturally, we developers wanted to get on board and use this model to generate inferences. Now, we are talking about the 405 billion parameter version. We can forget about running it on consumer hardware, but we can still use the API route to run inferences using it in our Next.js application. So this video is going to be slightly different. I'm not going to build a complete product as we do in this channel. Rather, I'm going to quickly show how you can run inferences using Llama 3.1 405 billion parameter version in your Next.js application. That is for completely free without entering your credit card information. Now, I have done my research finding out the way to implement this so that you don't have to. So as I mentioned, we will be using API providers for this full-size model. So the usual suspects for implementing this were Groq, Amazon Bedrock, Together.ai, and last but not least, the Hugging Face. So some quick housekeeping before we go any further. The video is strictly about using Llama 3.1 405 billion in Next.js. Now I have already created a tutorial where I have walked through the details of how to stream LLM responses in Next.js. As you know, you always want to stream the large language model responses as the complete response takes time to generate, and that is more true for large models that have lower tokens per minute. So I'm going to take a bare bones copy of that project. I'll leave a link to that right under this video in case you want to follow along. It's pretty basic one really, but it takes care of the streaming of large language responses in your app along with some nice to have features like displaying markdown syntax, etc. You can check out that video after this to get a deep dive into how to handle streaming and markdowns in Next.js. I'll also leave a link to the GitHub repository that will have the complete code of this tutorial. So in case you want to do hands-on later, you can simply bookmark that for later. Now, after you download that bare bones template and open it up in VS Code, you can quickly run npm install to install the packages and then spin up the app using npm run dev. So for the sake of being comprehensive, here the streaming works via Vercel's AI SDK, which has client-side use chat hook that exposes certain handlers that you need to hook up with your input and output elements basically. That kind of is it on the client side. As you can see, I have specified an API called API/LLM responses in the use chat hook. When this submit button is clicked, this API is going to be called. And I have defined the API/LLM response here, which is completely empty right now, just that we are extracting the prompt from the request payload. So on the API side, Vercel AI SDK provides an open AI provider, which basically is nothing but a universal wrapper that wraps the API request to any LLM provider, for example, Groq, Amazon Bedrock, Together.ai, etc., that conforms to the OpenAI standards. So if we go to the AI SDK documentation for Vercel, you can see that they are advertising Llama 3.1 is supported. I don't think Vercel had to do anything additional for supporting Llama 3.1. It's just that the API providers like Groq, Together.ai, etc., that already have API options, have just added Llama 3.1 in their backend, and Vercel's AI SDK may now access it. So you can see they have given code snippets for Groq. You first instantiate the OpenAI provider that comes from their package, which we mentioned. So const OpenAI is equal to create OpenAI, and this OpenAI comes from the OpenAI package, and it takes the base URL and the API key. Now we'll start with Groq as it is by far the most popular. If you're not familiar with Groq, it is a web platform which you can use to interact with LLMs using their UI as well as their API options. Now, if you go to console.groq.com, which is the API option of Groq, you can head over to the playground section and on the right, click on the view code. You can see code example here says that you can use it by installing additional packages. Like for Python, you install the Groq package using pip, and for JavaScript, you install the Groq SDK using npm. But since we are using an OpenAI wrapper anyway, hence we are just going to get the API endpoint URL from here, from this curl command here. We need to copy until just before chat completion. And we will also grab the API key while we are here. If it prompts for login, then it's pretty straightforward using Google or GitHub. Now back in our project's root, we'll create a .env file and save the API key for later use. Now back in the documentation, you can see that we need to call the stream text function, which will also come from the AI SDK package that we installed. So I'll copy this part here and paste it in our code. So you can see that in the example itself, they are mentioning that for Groq, we'll be able to use the Llama v3.1 405 billion model. For the prompt, I'll just pass the prompt that we extracted from the request payload. But if I run this, this will fail. It says model not found. So before you try to hit any OpenAI API for LLMs, you can always check the model names that are available for that endpoint. You can do that by sending a curl request. You can use Postman for this, even your terminal, but I'll use the Thunder Client extension in VS Code. If you don't have it, then just go to the extensions tab and install the Thunder Client so that you can send get or post requests to this API. Here I'll make a get request to the Groq endpoint. Just add the models at the end of the URL, and this get request does require authorization. So in the authorization tab, I'll add the API key in the bearer space. Here you can see they have Llama 3.1, but not the 405 billion model. So as it seems at the time of recording this, Groq still doesn't have the 405 billion model. Depending upon when you are watching this, they might have included it, and you can quickly cross-check using this method. And I think it is certainly going to come in Groq, as Meta's article here mentions Groq as their 405 billion model partner, among others. Now, before I move over to Together.ai or Fireworks.ai, both of which do host the 405 billion model, let me complete the Groq part here. So I can see that the 70 billion parameter version is there. I'll copy that name and paste it here in our code. I'll return the streaming result using two data stream response. This will make sure that on the client side, the useChat hook streams the incoming responses as and when they're generated by this API. Now, if you save everything and type hi there, we can see a very fast response coming through. I can ask, tell me a long story, and it's really, really fast. I barely had to hit enter and started generating responses. Since it's a much smaller model, probably that is the reason the tokens per second is so high. But now let's try the Together.ai, as we are after that humongous 405 billion option. We'll follow the same steps, that is, go to the API page, that is pretty straightforward login, copy the endpoint until the chat completion, grab API key while we are here, save the API key in the .env file. Here we just have to change the endpoint URL and the API key in our code. And for model name, why don't we move over to the Thunder Client again and hit the Together.ai endpoint. So I'll add slash models with the Together.ai API key in the bearer section. And here we can see that the 405 billion model does exist. I'll copy the model name and paste it in the code, and I'll keep the prompt same. And if you save and try it now, tell me a long story. We can see it is generating the response. So we have the 405 billion inference in our Next.js application right at this moment. Just to be comprehensive, I'll also do the same for Fireworks AI. Move over to their website, pretty straightforward login, get the endpoint URL until before the chat completion, get the API key, save the API key in the .env file, replace the endpoint in Next API along with the API key, move over to the Thunder Client to get a list of models from Fireworks endpoint, and don't forget to use the correct API key here. And here too, we can see that we have the 405 billion model. Use the model name here in the Next API, and you can test, tell me a long story, and success. Here also we can use the 405 billion model from Fireworks AI. And I've already checked the API option for the perplexity endpoint, and it seems that at the time of recording, they still don't have the 405 billion model. So I won't drag the video here. One thing to note though, both Together and Fireworks provide this via their limited free tier, so you get a fixed amount of free credits to use it. This does not require you to enter any credit card or any of that. And I'm not sure if or when we will see any API provider like Groq providing the full size model for free use, as this does require quite some hardware to run, which leads me to my last provider, the Hugging Face. If I go to the official model card, I can see inference API option is available for the 405 billion model, but if I type in something, it says it requires way more hardware than what is available in the serverless options. But that's fine, as we can still get some dedicated Hugging Face spaces that is hosting it, but I didn't get much luck there either, as it seems the spaces hosting it right now are either overloaded or not available. I'm working on a video which is going to show you how you can run this on consumer hardware using Llama. It's pretty straightforward, actually. Now, of course, I cannot promise the 405 billion model to run on consumer hardware, as according to this article, it takes humongous amounts of RAM, but 70 billion or 8 billion options should still be very easy to run using Llama. I'll do a comparison of that soon. So until that time, take care and thank you for watching.